As the world waited for the 2016 Summer Olympics, multiple concerns and controversies took center stage. Welcome to Watch Mojo News, the weekly series where we break down news stories that might be on your radar. In this installment, we're counting down 10 crucial facts you should know about the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio de Janeiro. Number 10. What is the current state of the 2016 Summer Olympics? The Olympic Games are one of the most anticipated events on the sporting calendar. And in 2016, they were scheduled to take place in Rio de Janeiro, with the opening ceremony set for August 5th. However, as host city, Rio is carrying a massive weight of expectation, and tournament organizers have been under constant scrutiny. With just weeks to go until the opening ceremony, the outbreak of the Zika virus, Brazil's troubled economy, health and hygiene problems, and mounting social unrest in the country are all ongoing concerns. Number 9. How will the Zika virus affect the Olympics? Doctors are warning that the Games could spark a, quote, full-blown public health disaster, thanks to the Zika virus, which was first recognized in Brazil in May 2015. The virus, which causes a dengue fever-like infection and has also been linked to microcephaly, a condition that sees babies born with improperly developed brains and dangerously small heads, has reached pandemic levels in parts of Central and South America. As a mosquito-borne and sexually transmitted condition, experts are concerned that the Olympics will fast-track Zika's international spread. According to Canadian biologist Amir Adaran, with about 500,000 foreign tourists expected in Brazil in the summer of 2016, the game should be moved to another less infected city at least, if not postponed entirely.
Some will become infected, some will go home, and that epidemic of brain-damaged kids will go global faster and farther.
Number 8. Who is leading Brazil? Brazil's political climate is increasingly tense, as President Dilma Rousseff has been suspended for allegedly doctoring government accounts. Brazil's Senate voted on May 12, 2016, to hold an impeachment trial against Rousseff. Vice President Michel Temer has stepped into Rousseff's role in the meantime, although there have been questions about his spending in the past as well. Rousseff has since labeled the situation as sabotage and an open conspiracy, suggesting that she has been ousted to make way for an all-male government.
When an elected president is suspended because of an accusation of a crime I haven't been committed, the name we give is not impeachment. It's coup.
Whatever the outcome of the trial, however, it seems unlikely that Rousseff will have any further involvement with the Olympics.
I will fight to survive, not just for my term in office, but I will fight because what I'm advocating and defending is the democratic principle that governs political place in Brazil.
Number 7. In what state is Brazil's economy? By 2014, Brazil had built the 7th largest economy on the planet and was tapped to become the next big international market. However, since then, the nation's finances have fallen spectacularly, and investors have all but lost faith in the country. Incoming President Temer has already identified the problem as his most pressing matter. Quote, "Brazil lives today in the worst economic crisis of our history," he said. "It is imperative that we rebuild the fundamentals of Brazilian economy." However, with the Olympics looming large, the country will still be mired in uncertainty when Rio hosts the Games, which have come to be viewed by some Brazilians as a symbol of government overspending. Number 6. What is the Petrobras investigation? An ongoing corruption investigation centered on the state-run oil firm Petrobras is another issue overshadowing the Games. As part of the inquiry, which was opened in 2014, allegations have also been made of fraud, price fixing, and bribery relating to construction contracts for Olympic venues. Dilma Rousseff was on the board of directors of Petrobras from 2003 to 2010, though she has consistently denied any knowledge of the company's illegal workings.
I am positive that Petrobras will be able to do so. It will be able to overcome all of its problems by late April.
The probe planned to scrutinize contracts for the Olympics in November 2015, when Brazilian police investigated the legitimacy of more than $10 billion linked to the building of venues. Number 5. Are the venues ready for the Olympics? Regardless of whether the stadiums were developed legally or not, time pressures have constantly dogged Rio's Olympic build. In February 2016, construction workers protested against the Olympic Committee over pay and warned organizers that venues were in danger of being unfinished when the Games rolled into town. However, although many deadlines have been missed, Brazil is confident that Rio will be ready for opening night and claims that competition venues are finished. The country has garnered a reputation for doing things at the last minute. 2014's World Cup was similar, but officials are hoping that the builders will move out just in time for the athletes to move in. Number 4. How do the Brazilian people feel about hosting the Olympics? Thanks to Brazil's problems, the country is currently experiencing severe social unrest. In a series of demonstrations, people have taken to the streets to rally against the government and protest the economic crisis.
Yes, the protesters want to forcibly remove their president. And as Brazilians know well, you don't want to remove something slowly and methodically, you want to do it quickly all at once.
Most commentators highlight how the Olympics have almost been forgotten. Such is the anger among Brazilian people right now. Often, the Games serve to unify a nation, to celebrate it, and to bolster its international image.
We want the Games to be the turnaround moment. We want the Games to bring good energy. We have been working for almost 10 years for this moment to happen.
But so far, that is not the case in Rio. In fact, the Olympics have come to represent everything that the people are angry about. They've so far proven to be badly organized and expensive, and they've drawn international attention to Brazil when perhaps the nation would prefer the rest of the world to be focusing elsewhere. Number 3. Will countries be excluded from the Olympics? The 2016 Summer Olympics faces more than just a myriad of external issues, however. There's mounting pressure within the sporting world itself, as authorities attempt to install stricter anti-doping laws. Russia is not the only country currently being investigated for drugs cheats, but it is the most high profile. The All-Russia Athletics Federation was suspended from competition in November 2015, following allegations that the country employs sophisticated and systematic doping methods.
The Council unanimously agreed that the Russian authorities need to undertake further significant work.
Nations including the Ukraine, Belarus, Ethiopia, Morocco, and Kenya are also threatened with a ban, as the World Anti-Doping Agency tries to make the Games as fair as possible. It remains to be seen if countries will be excluded thanks to doping, but in Russia's case, the suspension must be lifted before they can be represented in Rio. Number 2. Will the Olympics be widely attended? According to reports, ticket sales have not met expectations, and organizers are worried that the sporting spectacle could see thousands of empty seats. According to Fortune, only half of the tickets had been sold by April 2016. The city is said to be scrambling to sell more, but efforts are hindered by a lack of local interest in the Games and international concerns over the Zika virus. The Brazilian press has reported the tickets may even be given away to at least give the impression that venues are full. Brazil's Minister of Sports, Ricardo Lazer, hasn't given up hope, though. Quote, "There is a perception that the Brazilian population has not woken up for the Games. We need to sound an alert so that people remember this event and go and buy tickets," he said. Number 1. Will Rio be able to host the Olympic Games? The odds seem massively stacked against Rio. What might have been inspiring and enjoyable Games could become a nightmare for the city and the nation. The event simply hasn't captured the imagination of local residents, and it can't shake off health and safety concerns. However, if Laser can generate excitement, the city could yet stage a successful event. Rio is well known for its party atmosphere, and the World Cup wasn't the all-out disaster that some had predicted it would be. Perhaps the Olympics can follow suit. The political and economic turmoil won't disappear, but organizers will be hoping to prove that although the Games come at the wrong time, they're still being held in the right place. Did these facts get you thinking? To vote for which news story is covered next, head over to watchmojo.com/suggest and be sure to hit that subscribe button for more newsworthy top 10s published every week.